Let us continue nitrogen family. In the nitrogen family, we will take hydrides. We'll take hydrides of fifth group. That hydrides of fifth group bond length order we will see. Bond length order. Now, in the hydrides, ammonia, phosphine, arsine, stibine, bismuthine. Here, ammonia structure we can write like this. Nitrogen group number 5A, therefore this valence shell is having 5 electrons. Each this electron is making bond like this. For this, what is the bond length? For this bond length is how much? That's what we'll see. Okay, this NH bond. That NH bond, bond length is how much means 101.7 picometer. Okay. So down the group, how the bond length will be there? That we'll see. Down the group we are taking. Down the group, size of central atom. Size of central atom, what happens? You see, size of central atom increases. Therefore, bond length increases. This is our expectation. What is the experimental result? That we'll see. For NH3, in NH3, NH bond length is 101.7 picometer. Now, pH3. In pH3, pH bond length is 141.9 picometer. Arsine, ASH3, 157.9. Stibine, SBH3, 170.7. So, bond length increases, we can see. Next, we will see bond angle. We will see how the bond angle changes. That we will see. Bond angle in the sense, this is the angle. This bond angle, how it varies. Bond angle, how it varies, that we will see. Okay. In ammonia, we are taking like this. Ammonia structure we have taken. Then, phosphine structure we will take like this. Phosphine structure. Now, we will see the electronegativity. Electronegativity of nitrogen is 3, hydrogen is 2.1. Electronegativity of phosphorus is 2.1, hydrogen is 2.1. Now, this electronegativity is high, therefore bond pair is closer to this N. So, bond pair density closer to nitrogen is high. Here, electronegativity is same, therefore bond pair density closer to phosphorus is less when compared to nitrogen. Here, bond pair density closer to nitrogen is more when compared to phosphorus. Therefore, here bond pair repulsion is more. Here, bond pair repulsion is less. Therefore, since bond pair repulsion is less, bond pairs are coming closer. Therefore, bond angle is getting reduced here when compared to this. So, we can say bond angle here is less when compared to this one, we can say. Okay. So, now we will see in ammonia, the bond angle is how much we will see. In ammonia, the bond angle is 107.8 degree. In phosphine, the bond angle is 93.6 degree. In arsine, bond angle is 91.8 degree. In stibine, the bond angle is 91.3 degree. So, bond angle decreases. So, in the phosphine, arsine and stibine, here bond angle, if you see, nearly 90 degree is there. In the phosphine, arsine and stibine, if you see, the bond angle is nearly 90 degree. Why is it so? In these three, bond angle is nearly 90 degree. That means, here which orbitals are involving in bonding? In ammonia, the bond angle is 107.3 degree. Here which orbitals involving in bonding? Now, in the ammonia, central atom is nitrogen. That electronic configuration is helium, 2s2, 2s2, 2p3. It is the electronic configuration of nitrogen, 2p3. Now, in the nitrogen, in the ammonia, central atom nitrogen is having 3 sigma bonds and 1 lone pair. So, totally 4 electron pairs. 4 electron pairs. That 4, you divide it, you give 1 to S, remaining 3, you give to P. So, sp3 hybridization. so that this s orbital and these three p orbitals in intermixing to give sp3 hybridization. Therefore, in the ammonia, this NH bond is formed by sp3 orbital of nitrogen and s orbital of hydrogen. Sir, phosphine, in phosphine central atom phosphorus, that electronic configuration is neon 3s2 3p3. So 3s contains two electrons, 3p contains three electrons, that three electrons will write. Now hydrogen will take, hydrogen contains 1s1. Now we can say these two involve in overlapping to give sigma bond. That means in the phosphine, phosphorus gives this pure p orbitals for bonding with the hydrogen. Why? Because here bond angle is nearly 90 degree. Nearly 90 degree bond angle. Therefore, this pure p orbitals, if you take these two, these are separated by 90 degree. Therefore, in the phosphine, phosphorus gives pure p orbitals for bonding with the hydrogen atoms. Therefore, here if you see phosphine or same stibine, if you see, the bond angle is closer to 90 degree. That means in these central atoms providing pure p orbitals for bonding with the hydrogen. That's why the bond angle is nearly 90 degree, we are saying, sir. Next step, we'll see about bond dissociation energy. We'll see bond dissociation energy. Okay, now we are going for bond dissociation energy. Okay, now we will take ammonia. This, in this ammonia, we will convert this into, we will break all the bonds. So nitrogen in gaseous state will take, hydrogen atoms in gaseous state will get. Ammonia, in the ammonia, if you break all the bonds, all the sigma bonds, if you break, you will get a gaseous nitrogen atoms and gaseous hydrogen atoms you will get. For this, what is the energy required? That is called bond dissociation energy of ammonia, we can say. And average, if you take NH bond, this bond energy alone we will get, that is how much, means 389 for ammonia. Then phosphine, how it will be there? For phosphine also, if you break the bonds, you will get phosphorus atoms in gaseous state and hydrogen atoms in gaseous state. Now, in phosphine structure, we can write like this. Now, to break this bond, what is the energy required? That we'll see. To break this bond, what is the energy required? That is called bond dissociation energy of this pH bond. That value is how much when compared to ammonia, that we have to see. Now, you see that in the ammonia, central atom is nitrogen. In the phosphine, central atom is phosphorus. This nitrogen small size, phosphorus large size. So your overlapping extent will be high. Your overlapping extent will be low. Your bond strength is high. Your bond strength is low. So more energy required to break bond, less energy required to break bond. Therefore, your bond dissociation energy should be less when compared to this. Therefore, down the group, if you see, size of central atom increases, extent of overlapping with hydrogen decreases, so bond strength decreases, so bond dissociation energy also decreases. This is expectation. What experimental result says, that we'll see. As per experimental result, we'll talk. For phosphine, bond dissociation energy, how much, means 322. For arsine, bond dissociation energy is 297. For stibine, bond dissociation energy 255 kilojoule per mole. So how see? So bond dissociation energy decreases down the group, shall we say? Yes. Okay. Now down the group, bond dissociation energy decreases, we say. Now we will see thermal stability. We'll see. Now, if in the ammonia, if this bond is breaking, then it is converting into nitrogen and hydrogen atoms. To break this bond, this much energy is required. This is called average bond dissociation energy. In pH 3, if you break this bond, then you will get this P and this hydrogen atoms you will get. To break this bond, we have to supply this much energy. So here less energy we are supplying because bond strength is low. Here more energy we are supplying because bond strength is high. So here bond strength is high. Therefore, this thermal stability is high for this. Bond strength is low, therefore thermal stability is low for this. So down the group, what happens to the thermal stability? decreases. So thermal stability decreases, we are seeing. Now, in this ammonia, if you break this bond homolytically, you will get a hydrogen atom. This hydrogen atom can be used for reduction. Therefore, it is supplying hydrogen atom. It is helping other substance to undergo reduction by giving hydrogen. Therefore, it is called reducing agent. It is having reducing nature. It is having reducing nature, we can say. So, out of ammonia and phosphine, which is having higher reducing nature, that we will see. Here, this bond is having higher strength. This bond is having lower strength. So, it requires more energy to give hydrogen atom. It requires less energy to give hydrogen atom. So, it is giving hydrogen atom easily. It is not giving hydrogen atom easily. So, it is better reducing agent when compared to this. So, for this reducing nature is more, for this reducing nature is less. Therefore, down the group, what happens to the reducing nature? Increases, because bond dissociation energy decreases. So what happens to the reducing nature? That we got an idea. Okay, next, basic strength of these hydrides, we'll see. Now, ammonia in the sense, we will say example for ammonia is a weak base. Ammonia is a weak base, we will say, isn't it? So why it is acting as a base, that we'll see. Now it is having lone pair, therefore it is acting as a base. Okay, now we will take ammonia. This ammonia, central atom nitrogen, it is having lone pair. Now I will take H plus is having vacant 1s orbital, it is having. So vacant 1s orbital is there in H plus. Now what happens means these two go for overlap. Okay, this sp3 orbital. So nitrogen is contributing this lone pair. This H plus is contributing vacant orbital. Between them, overlapping takes place and bond is produced. What bond is produced? In the sense, dative bond is produced. Now dative bond is produced, we can say. Okay. Now in this case, this nitrogen is electron pair donor. Therefore, it is a base. Okay. Ammonia is coming under weak base, we are saying. So in the ammonia, nitrogen is acting as a basic electron pair donor. Okay. In the phosphine, phosphorus is having a lone pair. It is donating. Therefore, it is acting as a base. Okay. What about a basic strength? That we'll see. Basic strength, how it will be there? That we'll see. Now, nitrogen, size is small. Here, phosphorus, size is high. So here lone pair density is high. Here lone pair density is low. Therefore, it is having higher tendency to donate lone pair. It is having lesser tendency to donate lone pair. Therefore, for this basic strength is more, for this basic strength is less. Down the group, what happens to the size of central atom? Increases. So lone pair density decreases. So tendency to donate decreases. Therefore, basic strength decreases. So we can say down the group, basic strength decreases. So what is the order of basic strength? We'll see. Order of basic strength, ammonia greater than phosphine, greater than arsine, greater than stibine, greater than or equal to bismuthine. It is the order of basic strength, we can say. Sir, in the hydrides, order of basic strength we have seen. Next, we will see standard enthalpy of formation for hydrides. We will see standard enthalpy of formation for hydrides. So, first we will take a standard enthalpy of formation of ammonia. We will take how to write equation for that we will see. Standard enthalpy of formation of ammonia gas. For that, first we will write equation. Here, formation of ammonia. Therefore, here formation of ammonia. Therefore, we will write NH3 gas in the right side. NH3 gas we have written in the right side, we have written. Left side, what we have to do means constituent elements we have to write. Constituent elements means nitrogen is one constituent element, then hydrogen is another constituent element. Now we have to balance this equation by keeping ammonia as one mole. Therefore, here 1/2. Here 3/2 we will take. For this reaction, enthalpy change is called enthalpy of formation. That enthalpy of formation is how much in the sense -46.1 kilojoule per mole. Sir, next we will see for phosphine. We'll see how it will be there for phosphine. Okay, so for phosphine, enthalpy of formation is how much in the sense? 13.4 we can say. So enthalpy of formation here exothermic, but here endothermic. That means stability of ammonia is more when compared to phosphine. That's why here exothermic, here endothermic. Okay, so how the enthalpy of formation will be there for other species? That we will see. For other species, for arsine. For arsine, how much means 66.4. That means more endothermic when compared to phosphine. Then stibine we will take. Stibine we are taking. For stibine, how much in the sense? That is stibine 145.1. For bismuthine. For bismuthine 278. So that phosphine endothermic is nature is 13.4. Arsine endothermic nature is more. Stibine still more. Bismuthine still more. For which one only exothermic? For ammonia only exothermic. Therefore, ammonia is more stable when compared to other hydrides. Sir. Then let us pass ammonia into water. It is a dissolving. And we will pass phosphine into water. It is not dissolving. Ammonia dissolving in water, but phosphine not dissolving in water. What is the reason? Ammonia makes hydrogen bond with water, whereas phosphine is not making hydrogen bonding with water. Therefore, ammonia dissolving in water, whereas phosphine is not dissolving in water. Okay. Next, we will see oxides of 50A group. We will see. Now, we will see oxides. Oxides of 50A group elements, we will see. Okay. Now, 50A group elements generally form which oxidation states? One is plus 3, another one is plus 5. Next to minus 3. Oxides in the sense, we need not take minus 3, we need not take. Minus 3 don't take if you take oxides. Because oxides in the sense, oxygen will have negative oxidation number. 50A group will have positive oxidation number. Okay, sorry. Plus 3 oxidation state means M2O3. Plus 5 oxidation state means M2O5. Okay, sorry. First, nitrogen. Nitrogen is N2O3. Pentoxide is N2O5. Next, phosphorus. P2O3. Pentoxide is P2O5. Next, arsenic. As2O3. Pentoxide is As2O5. Next, antimony. Trioxide is Sb2O3. Pentoxide is Sb2O5. Bismuth. Ba2O3. Then Bi2O5. Okay, like this oxides we have written. Now, these oxides. Now, if we go like this, what happens to the acidic nature? What happens to the acidic nature? We'll see. Now, N2O3 we will take. N2O3 with water. What we will get? We'll see. N2O3 with water, we will get 2 times HNO2. Nitrous acid. This is called what means nitrous acid. Nitrous acid. N2O5 with water, we'll see. N2O5 with water. N2O5 with water in the sense HNO3, this is called nitric acid, we can say. You know that nitric acid is more strength when compared to nitrous acid. Out of these two, which is having higher acidic strength in the sense, nitric acid is having higher strength, acidic nature. It is having lower acidic strength. So for this acidic strength is more, for this acidic strength is less, because here it is plus 5 oxidation state, it is plus 3 oxidation state. So, if oxidation number varies, then acidic strength also varies. Why is it so? On changing the oxidation number, why acidic nature varies? For these oxy acids, that we will see. Now, HNO2 we will write. HNO2 we will write like this. Nitrogen is having 5 electrons in its valence shell. This oxygen makes a double bond. Here single bond, here single bond. Here nitrogen is plus 3 oxidation number. HNO3 will take nitrogen. 3 oxygens will take, hydrogen will give. Nitrogen is having 5 electrons in its valence shell. Here single bond, here double bond. Nitrogen can make 3 normal covalent bonds and 1 dative bond. So dative bond we have written. Now, which is having more acidic strength, that we will see. Now, this oxygen shows minus I effect. Therefore, this bond move towards oxygen. Therefore, here nitrogen getting deficiency. Therefore, this bond is moving towards nitrogen. So, oxygen getting deficiency. Therefore, this bond is moving towards oxygen. Therefore, hydrogen losing the electron and comes out as H plus. Since this gives H plus, it is having acidic nature, we are seeing. Then this oxygen minus I effect show, it shows. Therefore, this bond is moving towards oxygen. This bond also moving towards oxygen, minus I effect. Nitrogen getting deficiency because of these two oxygens. Therefore, this bond is moving towards nitrogen. This oxygen is getting deficiency. Therefore, this bond is moving towards hydrogen. Therefore, hydrogen is losing the electron and comes out as H plus. So, this species is giving H plus. Therefore, it is acid, we can say. Now, out of HNO2 and HNO3, which is more acidic in the sense HNO3 when compared to HNO2? Okay. So, if oxidation number is high, then acidic strength will be high for oxy acids. With this we are calling as oxy acids. Oxy acids means OH group will be there. That OH group will donate H plus. Therefore, this OH group is responsible for acidic nature. Okay. So, if we go like this, what happens? Oxidation number increases. Therefore, acidic nature, what happens? Increases, we can say. If you go down, what happens in the sense? What happens to the acidic strength? If you go down, what happens to the acidic strength? We will see, for which we will take an example. N2O5. N2O5 with water, we got HNO3, we got. N2O5 with water, we got HNO3. HNO3, we are saying strong acid. P2O5 with water, we are getting H3PO4. H3PO4, we are saying weak acid. It's a Ka1. Ka1 is nearly 10 to the power of 3, minus 3. It's Ka1 is nearly 10 power minus 3. Therefore, H3PO4 is a weak acid, we can say. So, HNO3 is strong acid, H3PO4 is weak acid. That means, why is it so? Why like this happening? That we'll see. Now, nitric acid will take, nitric acid we can write like this. Nitric acid we are taking like this. H3PO4 we will write. H3PO4 we are writing like this. It is a tribasic acid. Therefore, 3 OH groups you give it. Okay. So, here nitrogen is plus 5. Here phosphorus is plus 5. Nitrogen size is small. Nitrogen size is small. Electronegativity is high. That is 3. Phosphorus size is high. Electronegativity is low. That is 2.1. So, here which is more electronegative in the sense? Nitrogen is more electronegative. So, it is pulling this bond with more tendency when compared to phosphorus. Therefore, this bond is easily shifting, but this bond is not easily shifting. So, that its H plus donation capacity is more when compared to this. Therefore, here acidic strength is more, whereas here acidic strength is low. So, we are saying nitric acid is strong acid, H3PO4 is weak acid. Actually, in H3PO4, 3 OH groups are there. These 3 OH groups are giving 3 H plus ions. But HNO3, only 1 OH group is there. This 1 OH group will give 1 H plus only. Even then, HNO3 is strong acid, whereas H3PO4 is weak acid because Ka1 is 10 power minus 3. Ka2, if you see, how much means nearly 10 power minus 7. Ka3, if you see, nearly 10 power minus 11. Why Ka1, Ka2, Ka3? Because it can donate 3 H plus ions. Therefore, this Ka value is very low. Therefore, it is coming under weak acid. This HNO3 is strong acid. Okay. Therefore, size of central atom increasing means what happens to acidic strength? Decreases. Because it is strong acid, it is weak acid. Therefore, down the group if we go, what happens to acidic strength in the sense? Acidic strength decreases. This side if we go, acidic strength increases because oxidation number increases. N2O3 and N2O5, if you see, N2O5 is more acidic oxide when compared to N2O3. P2O5 is more acidic oxide when compared to P2O3. But down the group, if you see, P2O3 acidic strength is less when compared to N2O3. P2O5 acidic nature is lesser than that of N2O5. Like this, we can say. So, we can say acidic nature of oxides in this way. Next, we will take in the fifth A group, halides we will take. halides we will take. This halides, how the characters are there for halides, that we'll see. Now, halides in the sense, one is MX3, another one is MX5. Trihalides and another one is pentahalides. Nitrogen, if we take NF3, PF3, ASF3, SBF3, BAF3. Like this one example we said. Like this NCl3, NBr3, Ni3, like this also we can say. Pentahalides, if you see phosphorus, PCl5, arsenic, ASCl5, antimony, SBCl5, bismuth, BACl5. Like this pentahalides we have given. Now, in this one, nitrogen, if you see NCl5, not possible. Nitrogen cannot exist pentahalide. That means nitrogen pentahalide means structure we have to give like this structure is not possible. This NCl5 is not existing. Why nitrogen is not showing pentahalide? Because nitrogen electronic configuration is helium 2s2 2p3. In 2s, two electrons are there, pair of electrons are there. In 2p3, unpaired electrons are there. In the valence shell, no more vacant orbitals. No more vacant orbitals. These three unpaired electrons, these three unpaired electrons can form three normal covalent bonds, three single bonds. This electron pair can make dative bond only. But if you want NCl5, nitrogen should make five single bonds. That availability is not there. That possibility is not there. Nitrogen can make three single bonds only. Okay, nitrogen maximum covalency is four. So nitrogen can form maximum four covalent bonds only, not five covalent bonds. Therefore, NCl5 is not possible. That means nitrogen cannot form pentahalide. Okay, rest of the elements can form pentahalides, we are saying. Okay, next, Pa5 is not existing. Why not existing means iodine size is large. Therefore, Pa5 is not existing, we can say. Okay, iodine size is large in the sense, then how five iodine atoms will occupy the surrounding place? Cannot. Therefore, Pa5 is unstable. Therefore, Pa5 is cannot existing. Pa5 is not existing. Okay. Now, pentahalide and trihalide, we will take pentahalide and trihalide, which is a more covalent nature, that we will see. This is this we can say as per Poisson's rule. As per Poisson's rule, what we can say means if size of cation increases and size of anion decreases, then ionic nature, percentage of ionic nature increases. Okay, size of cation is rising, size of anion is reducing, then percentage of ionic nature is rising. That means percentage of covalent nature is reducing. Okay, like this we can say. It is Poisson's rule. Now MX5, MX3. MX5, it is M is plus 5 oxidation state. MX3, M is plus 3 oxidation state. Oxidation number is more means size of cation is less. Oxidation number is less means size of cation is high. Therefore, size of cation is less here. Size of cation is more here. Size of cation is more. Therefore, here covalent nature is less. Therefore, covalent nature is like this is there. So, which halides is having higher covalent nature in the sense pentahalides are having higher covalent nature when compared to trihalides. Okay. Among the trihalides, which is having highest ionic nature? Ionic nature, which is having higher ionic nature means size of anion should be low. Which anion will have least size? F minus. Therefore, BaF3 is having higher ionic nature among the trihalides. Among the trihalides, BaF3 is having higher ionic nature, we are seeing. Sir. Next, nitrogen forms trihalides. Nitrogen forms trihalides, that is NF3, NCl3, NBr3, Ni3. Nitrogen forms trihalides like this. Okay. In this one, this NF3 is stable. Rest are unstable. Rest are unstable. Okay. NF3 is stable. Rest of the trihalides of nitrogen is what in the sense unstable. in the nitrogen trihalides. Okay. Other trihalides are there, no, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, other trihalides. Those trihalides are stable. In the nitrogen trihalides, NF3 alone stable, remaining are unstable, we can say. Then how the stability order will be there, we'll see. NF3 greater than NCl3, greater than NBr3. Like this, stability order is there for the trihalides of nitrogen, we can say. Next, we can say basic strength. How the basic strength will be there, we'll see. NF3 less than NCl3, less than NBr3, less than Ni3. Okay, like this basic strength is there. Here we are saying that NF3 is having lesser basic strength. Why is it so when compared to NCl3? That we'll see. Now, NF3 we can write like this. NF3 we are writing like this. If this nitrogen is having lone pair. This nitrogen is a donating lone pair. Therefore, it is we are saying that it is base. Then NCl3 we will take. This nitrogen is having lone pair. It is this nitrogen is a donating. Therefore, it is having basic nature. Now, if you see, now we will take a electronegativity value. We will take electronegativity of fluorine is 4, nitrogen is 3. Here nitrogen is 3, Cl is 3.2. So electronegativity order, if you see, electronegativity of surrounding atom is high. Therefore, this bond pair is shifting towards fluorine. So here electron pair density decreases. Therefore, we can say lone pair density is less here, whereas lone pair density is more here. Therefore, which is having more basic strength, do you think? So we can say NCl3 basic strength is greater than NF3. Likewise, NBr3 is greater than NCl3. Ni3 is greater than NBr3. Like this we are saying. So what about phosphorus trihalides? How the basic strength will be there? Same like nitrogen. PF3 is less than PCl3, is less than PBr3, is less than Pi3. Okay. Trihalides, phosphorus trihalides is having basic strength like this. Then this, now we will take NF3 and PF3. Which can form complex, which cannot form complex, that we'll see. NF3 is unable to form complexes, but PF3 is ability to form complex. PF3 is a forming complex, but NF3 is not forming complex. Complex means what? In the complex, central metal will be there, and surrounding the central metal, ligands will be there. Between central metal and ligand, dative bond will be there. Ligand is electron pair donor here. Central metal is electron pair acceptor. Now, NF3. In NF3, nitrogen is having less tendency to donate electron pair. Therefore, it is not forming complex. It is not making a metallic, not making bond with the central metal. So, it is not forming complex. But PF3, in the central atom is phosphorus, is having lone pair. It can donate, it can contribute lone pair. Therefore, PF3 forms several complexes, we are seeing. Okay. Next, we will see hydrolysis of halides, we'll see. Now we are seeing hydrolysis of halides. We are seeing about hydrolysis of halides, we'll take. Now first, what we'll take in the sense, NCl3 undergoing hydrolysis with water, that we'll take. Okay. So NCl3 we'll write like this. NCl3 we are writing like this. Here nitrogen is having lone pair. Okay. So how it is going for hydrolysis, that point we'll see. How the hydrolysis takes place, that point we'll see. Now water will take. In the water, this oxygen is having lone pair. This oxygen is having lone pair, we can say. This oxygen is donating lone pair to the Cl. This bond is migrating. Therefore, this oxygen is a contributing lone pair. So oxygen getting positive charge. So this bond is migrating to oxygen. Hydrogen is losing the electron, therefore H plus, that is attacking this. Okay, that means in the place of Cl, what is going here? Hydrogen. This O is making bond with Cl in the same way other two Cl. Therefore, in NCl3, Cl is replaced by hydrogen. Cl and OH becomes HOCl, hypochlorous acid. This is called what in the sense? Hypochlorous acid, we can say. So NCl3 undergoes hydrolysis to give what in the sense? Ammonia and hypochlorous acid. Now we will take NF3. NF3 with water. Hydrolysis giving what product? That we will see. Now we will take NF3. NF3 will take. Now the water is coming here. Water is having electron pair. Now it is trying to donate to which one in the sense? To fluorine. Fluorine is unable to accept electron pair from water of oxygen. In the NF3, fluorine is unable to accept electron pair of oxygen of water because in fluorine, no vacant orbital in the valence shell. But NCl3, if you take, in NCl3, Cl is accepting electron pair from oxygen of water because Cl is having vacant 3D orbital in its valence shell. But in NF3, no vacant orbital. Even nitrogen valence shell also is not having vacant orbital. Therefore, NF3 cannot undergo hydrolysis, we can say. Next, we'll take PF3. We'll take what is how PF3 goes for hydrolysis, that we'll see. Now we are taking PF3. That PF3 we'll write a structural formula. We will write that PF3 we have written like this. And phosphorus is having lone pair, we have written. Now hydrolysis, we'll see. We'll take water. In water, central atom oxygen is there, that is having two lone pairs. Now this oxygen is a donating lone pair here. This bond is migrating towards F. Okay. Therefore, this oxygen is contributing lone pair in the sense oxygen is getting deficiency. So this bond is shifting to oxygen. Therefore, hydrogen is leaving as H plus. This H plus takes this F minus and becomes what in the sense HF. So now we can say that in this one, we'll take suppose PCl3 plus water gives what in the sense H3PO3 plus HCl. So for balancing, we will write like this. Okay. So PCl3 undergoes hydrolysis to give H3PO3 and HCl, we can say. So regarding PCl3, we said how it is going for hydrolysis, we said. Okay. So what is the product obtained means H3PO3 and HCl product. Then PCl5. PCl5 undergoes hydrolysis to give what in the sense H3PO4 and HCl. Okay, like this possible. So PCl5 on hydrolysis gives H3PO4. PCl3 on hydrolysis gives H3PO3. Okay, sir. Next, we'll say that NF3 is not undergoing hydrolysis, we said. NCl3 is undergoing hydrolysis, we said. Why NF3 is not undergoing hydrolysis? Because in nitrogen valence shell, no vacant orbital. In fluorine valence shell also, no vacant orbital. So NF3 is not undergoing hydrolysis. What about NCl3? NCl3 undergoing hydrolysis because Cl is having vacant 3D orbital. Therefore, water is attacking Cl. Okay. In PF3, central atom phosphorus is having vacant orbital. Water oxygen is attacking phosphorus of central atom. Therefore, PCl3 undergo hydrolysis to give what in the sense H3PO3. PCl5 undergoes hydrolysis to give H3PO4 in the same way, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. Okay. So PCl3 trihalide on hydrolysis gives us acid. Pentahalide on hydrolysis gives ic acid. Okay. So PCl3 on hydrolysis gives H3PO3. PCl5 on hydrolysis gives H3PO4. Like this we are saying. So now we said regarding hydrolysis. Regarding hydrolysis, we said, okay. Conclusion is what in the sense? NF3 cannot undergo hydrolysis because nitrogen and fluorine both not having vacant orbitals. NCl3 undergoes hydrolysis because Cl is having vacant orbital. PF3, ASH3, SBH3, BAH3, these and all can go for hydrolysis. The trihalide on go for hydrolysis to give us acid. Pentahalide on hydrolysis gives ic acid, we can say. This is about halides.